next speaker is someone who was a successful area governor, division governor, district governor, very successful district governor, went on to become international director, the only person I know with 8 DTMs and an excellent debater, and that's all I'm going to say, otherwise his hat won't fit anymore. Richard Snyder, opportunity knock, opportunity knock, Richard Snyder.
Who's there?
Who's there? Opportunity.
No.
Opportunity? What do you want? Get out of here!
Mr. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, what do you do when opportunity knocks? Do you run and hide? Or do you throw open the door and embrace opportunity? I hope after my speech today, you do the latter. Studies show that most people run from opportunity when opportunity knocks because they're afraid of the big C. Please raise your hand if you're married. Fair amount of you. You who raised your hand, you know what the big C is. My wife, for over 20 years, said if you're not committed after 20 years of marriage, you should be. The big C is commitment. We're afraid of committing. What happens if I fail? I don't know if I can. We're so afraid of committing that we're missing out on opportunities for better jobs, promotions, relationships. I have to admit, I used to be a runner. I would hear opportunity, and I would run the opposite way. It all started many, many years ago. My mother would yell, "Children, I have an opportunity. Let's have a party." My brothers and I would come running like little puppy dogs. Today's opportunity is we're going to clean the house. We're going to have a house cleaning party. And I learned that opportunity is a code word for an ugly four-letter word. W-O-R-R-K. And so an opportunity, I ran. Until one day I had one of those life-changing events. It was 1980 and I was okay. I was a sophomore in high school. And like many teenagers, I discovered the opposite sex. No. One girl in particular. Her name was Terry. She had long brown hair that cascaded down her back like a waterfall. Big, large, mysterious brown eyes. An infectious smile. Terry was gifted musically. Her first year in high school, she played first chair flute. I played clarinet in the second row. Only I was on the other end of the spectrum. But every quarter, we had an audition. And through practice, I moved closer and closer and closer. And by the beginning of my second year in high school, I was second chair clarinetist. This was the perfect spot in the band for me. Terry was just to my right. In math class, our roles were just reversed. You see, Terry had a figure that turned heads, but she did not have a head for figures. Many times I would hear her say, "Richard, what'd you get for number 3? I don't get number 8. We would meet during lunch, before and after, to prepare for a quiz or test that day. Things were going pretty well. I liked Terry, and I could see some signs that she liked me. Like when she'd take out her pen and give me a pen massage in math class. It sent shivers down my spine. One day, during one of our math training cramming sessions, she suddenly asked me, "Richard, did you know that Saturday is Sadie Hawkins Day?" "Yeah, so?" "That's the day the girl gets to ask the guy out." This is sounding pretty good. "Will you take me to the Sadie Hawkins dance Saturday night?" Suddenly my mind went back to dancing lessons in the living room with my mother. Ouch! And before I knew it, I blurted out, "I can't dance!" Well, Terry and I slowly drifted apart after that. And several years later, when I moved out of state to pursue a higher degree, I thought it was over. But a few years after that, after graduating, I returned to Iowa, and Terry was one of the first person I called. After all, I'd had dancing lessons in college. "Hi, may I please speak with Terry?" "Who's this?" "This is Richard Snyder, a former classmate." Terry was killed in an automobile accident in February. Door of opportunity slammed shut. I learned something that day. Life doesn't always give us a second chance. So we better say yes to opportunity. And a few years later, another cute brunette and I crossed our paths. And she asked me if I'd dance. I said, "I do now." Some 20 years later, I'm proud to say we're still married, and she's the mother of my two children. So say yes to opportunity. Great things happen when you say yes. What are you going to do? Mr. Toastmasters.